Godiva is closing or selling all 128 of its brick and mortar stores in North America. They're going to keep stores open across Europe, the Middle East, and Greater China. But I am just so sad about this. After working in the Mall of America for a while, nothing is exciting anymore. But the Godiva store was. It was my favorite store to go to get my chocolate covered strawberries. So I'm just so
Why?
sad. They're so good. They're like
What
the
is it about
size
these
of
strawberries? Why does everyone
they're like
talk
the
about these
size of your
strawberries?
fist.
Are
They're
they that
huge.
big?
Yes, I don't know what kind of hormones are in them,
They're
but
like
they're so
hormone
good.
strawberries?
They're so good, and the chocolate is so good. And there's just something about the experience of like watching the chocolatiers in the back, putting the chocolate on the strawberries and everything.
Oh, so it's
But my big,
experiential too? Is that what it is?
I know you hate that word, but like it
I
is
do.
kind of an experience to go in there and watch the
Okay.
chocolate and like the dripping and everything. But my thing with this story is I think it's going to be really hard for Godiva to exist without these stores in the US. No one really goes to Godiva's website to purchase chocolate. And if you want your strawberries, like edible arrangements is the way to go there. They just have the like fulfillment across the country ready for them.
So
But
that's
I'm
interesting.
feeling
Stores impact the brand perception and recognition of Godiva. That Godiva wouldn't have that without their stores. That's your thesis.
yeah,
That's your point.
it ups the like you can get a bag of individually wrapped Godiva chocolates at, Stop and Shop pulling in my hometown there. But like, I think it does up the brand that you can get that more kind of luxury chocolate in person. So.
Okay, all right, interesting. I'm also like the fact that I'm now conceiving of like a chocolate covered strawberry as somebody that suffers from diverticulitis, worst nightmare. Like, oh my God, that sounds like a horrible combination. But anyway, and I think this story is huge too. I'm with Emma. Like, that's a ton of locations that you're just getting out of. Emma's saying it's going to be a huge hit to brand perception and reputation. What are you thinking?
I mean, do we need to get Werther's Original as a sponsor? Diverticulitis, Godiva closing. Jeez, you guys, what the hell? You know what? I'm not going out to a mall in a pandemic to get Godiva chocolate. Okay. Number one, this makes complete sense. Nobody
It's
was,
a pandemic story.
I was looking actually to see if like Placer or somebody had data that would tell us how many people have actually set foot into a Godiva in the last year and a half. I'll even go back 2 years just to see like what foot traffic looked like. Because let me tell you, this is like no surprise to me. I think that you don't have a brand that has much cachet anymore. Like Godiva to me, yes, it's maybe a good product, but there's no like uniqueness. I mean, are Gen Zs really being like, let me give you this box of Godiva chocolate? No, they're going to like these, individual producers that they find on Instagram that are based in Brooklyn, New York. Like, it's just there's no cachet to the brand anymore. So the
Yes.
stores make no sense at all. I would even contest the
Yes.
experiential part of it because I don't think that the
100%.
store, like, every time I would go buy a Godiva store, and even when I worked in the malls a long time ago, it was rare that people were in there unless it was a holiday. I think if they're going to do a store, it's much more affordable. It makes much more sense to target this around key times of the year, like holidays, Valentine's Day, whatever.
100%. I agree with you, and I think that's why this story. I know you hated this story, and that I fought like hell to get this story in. But I think that's why this story matters. Is like, I disagree with Emma on this one. I agree with you, and I don't think the stores matter for the experience. And I think that's the message here to me, and the aha for me overnight as I was thinking about this story, is experiential doesn't mean physical. Don't link those two things in your head necessarily. Let's go back to what we just talked about, Instacart and fulfillment. You know what I'd be doing if I was a CPG? And I'm actually keynoting the National Confectioners Association meeting here in a few weeks. And I'm going to say this. I'd be investing like hell in Instacart and DoorDash. And I'd be thinking about how do I just milk the e-commerce space to create that experiential feeling online that you're actually really going for? Because you're agnostic. You don't care where people buy Godiva. It's everywhere. But you want people to know Godiva. You want their mouth to water about Godiva. And you can do that through all the things that are out there with e-com and exhaust that before you think you can just go up in stores where you got to move a ton of units to make those things work. And the pandemic makes that virtually impossible now. So I think that's the big takeaway. And brand CPGs particularly have to think about that. And the key there is divorce experience from physicality. Those aren't one in the same thing. And a lot of pundits need to start talking like that, in my opinion.